Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He can run for it, and he will. They're able to keep the drive alive 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And oh, what a catch that time by Landry. The Dolphin passing game rolling here. They've got another first down. First down now, but that clock rolling. Back to throw. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
It's easy to see when we review this that the ball needs to come out quicker, because if you don't throw it right on the break, you bring a crowd of people into the equation.
And that's why it got knocked away there. They'll look to throw. He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Tyler Lockett, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Dolphins able to get this back within a touchdown.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're...
They'll try and throw for it here. Being chased out left. He may try and run for this. A big pickup of 12 yards on fourth down to keep this drive from stalling. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now. First and 10 at the 43. They'll drop the throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. It's caught at the 10. And he's able to get this down deep on the Giants' side of the field. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. They'll set up a throw. Forced out to his left. They'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
No. Check. Patriot! Patriot!
They'll give it to him up the middle. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. Call it no gain that time, and now it's 3rd and goal. So stuff for no gain on 2nd down brings up a pretty interesting 3rd from this distance.
I'm throwing the ball, and I'm not even thinking about play pass. I'm going to let them know right away I'm throwing it, but I'm probably giving my quarterback some room, sprint him out to one side or the other, and give him an opportunity. If it breaks down, he can take off and run for it.
Now here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete. And now before this 4th-and-2 play comes to fruition, they're going to think about it and call a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this 3rd quarter. Now back to throw. And that will be caught, but out of the end zone, says the field judge. It's ruled incomplete. They're turned away on 4th-and-goal. And this Giants defense able to come up with a goal line stand. They'll start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. And not much there as he gets it up to about the 5-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
They didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. It's caught, Shepard. And they work this out past the 25. And they convert on third with a gain of 22. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down. So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
Now Saquon Barkley, and that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. It's the Giants with the football and also the lead as we get set to start. Back-to-back running plays, putting him in negative territory. What can they do coming up on third and 15?
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
They'll set up to throw. He gets it to Brown, complete. Pass the 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Juwan Brown. His first touchdown of the year. And the Giants are able to grow their lead. Great corner route there. Not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You've got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field and you're breaking away to that corner. Boy, that was well executed.
PAT up and good by Rosas. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. The return man is Grant. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Dolphins offense now ready to go back out onto the field. And last time, they had it fourth and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
A simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up, second and 10. Back to throw now on second and 10. Looking left side, that's caught by Landry. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down.
Face mask, defense.
Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all, and now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
He'll drop to throw. And his throw here's incomplete. He started out having some troubles back in the first half connecting with his receivers. Really hasn't gotten a whole lot better.
Yeah, he's at less than 50%, and you and I both know that just won't do. So I would think about spreading things out, putting it on the receivers, make them win those one-on-one battles on the perimeter and find their way open.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Catch number 44 on the year. It's a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Back to throw here. He dumps it off to Drake. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Call it a 3-yard gain, and it's a second down.
Leopard! Leopard!
They'll look to throw here. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. The Dolphins on third down, lacking much success. Just 2 for 7 to this point. This is third and 7.
All right, here we go. 3-19.
Looking to throw. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And down to the 16-yard line. That catch puts him over 70 yards receiving now as he's got a first down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. As his guys are in for 6. And the Dolphins have got it back to a 1-score game. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic. But usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And New York set to take the field. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a 1-score game. And you hear a lot about 2-minute offense and 4-minute offense. Obviously, the 4-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Get rid of the foot.
The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys that you turn loose to try and get to the guy who's going to throw the football. The tackles, usually more of the run stuff in variety. But the way this game is advanced, you're wanting a little bit of everything out of all of your guys. But let's just go ahead and break it down and make it simple. The guy who's the right defensive end versus a right-handed quarterback, that's the blind side. He's going after the quarterback. He's going to put him on the ground.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And incomplete on the deep ball. Here's Riley Dixon now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Returnable here from the 38. So a change of possession here on the punt. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50, first and 10. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. And there are the numbers. Got off to that torrid hot start. We thought he was in for maybe a career day. Not the case.
No doubt.
And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42. Marcus Golden, he's the one to get him. And that's sack number 7 for him on the year. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Know where to go with the football. That led to the sack.
And they finally bring him down, but he reaches the 16. It's a big play there for Miami. 42 yards. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. To the right side, and he's got Landry complete. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post. Because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Back to throw. And he slings one that's incomplete. This defense has watched their lead dwindle away. This is where they really need to bow up. They executed well there.
And it's often hard after you've played really well early and then you kind of relax a little bit. To step on the gas again. They just did it on the last play. Looks like they want to finish this one off.
They'll look to throw. This will be caught at about the 6. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down.
Oh, I know it goes against the grain here. It totally goes against it, but you've got to drop the ball in that situation. He makes a catch, but he loses yards and doesn't get out of bounds.
Back to throw. And that is incomplete. Jabril Peppers, a former first-round pick, there on the coverage. He has had a great game defensively. He's been east-west, north-south, everywhere.
Yeah, and I love how you described that, because to be a great defender, you have to be able to move up and back, sideline to sideline, and he's been fantastic. Reminds me of a young Charles Davis when he was playing Madden.
Absolutely. Oh, wow. I thought you were going on the field, but okay, I see you. They go for it on fourth and goal, but that winds up incomplete. So now let's reset here, Charles. They do have two timeouts left, so they can stop the clock twice. This one's not quite over yet.
No, and what you're doing on defense, you're going to use both timeouts, obviously. But you've got to call defenses are going to force the issue early, meaning you want that play over fast. You don't want to give them time to dance around in the backfield and run a wide sweep that'll take off time. Blitz them, put pressure on them, make sure that play ends quickly so that you can go ahead and keep moving.
They'll go to Barkley again, and he'll be hit and dropped for a loss at the 5-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here, as he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now, third and long. On third down, Barkley. And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down.
Brandon, you're a big lover of music. How about what you just saw there? This is what I call playing the piano for a defensive lineman. The ability to move laterally up and down the line of scrimmage. How about the way he just flowed and got to the outside part of the field and made that play?
And he is out of bounds inside the 35. An excellent return that time, 26 yards. And the Dolphins will begin this drive in great field position, first and 10. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
All right, here we go. 3-19.
He's back to throw. His throw caught at about the 5. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Tyler Lockett with time running out. And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And, partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And New York set to take the field. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to have the hookup to Izzo. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
Well, that answers the question in my head. They're going to go for the win right now.
I think you're absolutely right. They're not content with going to OT. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
Checking the NFL scoreboard there in the fourth now in Minneapolis. For the moment, it's the Vikings who lead that one. Kirk Cousins. 3 touchdown passes thus far. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of
Going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition, let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
As we said, they control their own destiny now. Now a handoff looking right, and he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. He lost two there, and it's third down. He's had some big runs in this game, not there though.
But I don't think they're going to be deterred by that play right there. He's had some nice runs in the game, and how many times have we seen a good running back get stopped, yet turn it into something big on a later carry? I'd stay with him.
He'll look to throw. Hard throw, incomplete. The temptation to go for it, probably there. Always is, especially in overtime. Gotta punt it, though.
I think you're right. Yeah, I think that you absolutely have to punt it away and trust your defense, especially play a little field position here. But you're so right about the temptation. Another way to satisfy that, though, line up in punt formation and fake it. That's another way to get it done.
Great coverage there. Holds him to a 2-yard return following a 50-yard punt. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. They begin with a run by Barkley, and he will lose yardage on the play, back at his own 19-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
All right, here we go. Green, 39.
He'll look to throw. Over the middle, Juwan Brown's got it. And he's able to get up here to the 26. The reception good for 7. It's third down. 2 minutes to go here in overtime. We'll be back after this. The Giants on third down. 5 out of 9 thus far. This is 3rd and 4.
Set. Green 39. Green 39.
They're going to look to throw. They'll set up the screen to Barkley. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. And they'll get 14 yards out of it and a fresh set of downs. This is a big spot for a rookie QB, and overtime's kind of where you earn your stripes, isn't it?
It really is, and we've talked with enough coaches and players about how these youngsters are getting into the game and playing this at such a high level so early. But overtime, that's an entirely different animal, and he's handling it well.
Yeah, starting to put together a nice drive. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So 2nd down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40.
Set. Blue line. Blue line.
Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A good pickup there of 22.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right? Whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And that one results in 35 yards. Coaches love the rack run after catch, especially here in overtime. Took the short pass, turned it into a big play.
And that's what coaches talk about when they talk to their teams about what overtime means. How many big plays have to be made in order to win a ball game, and which play will be the big play. Short pass turned into a long run. Maybe that's the play that they needed to spring a victory.
Back at the 2 now. Here's 2nd and goal.
Gone.
And Barkley will try to punch it in. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the 1. All right, well, they didn't kick it on 2nd down, now 3rd and goal. You have to kick it here.
Absolutely have to kick it, because if you get a bad snap, you fall on it, you got a chance to kick it again on 4th down. Let's say it gets blocked.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Dolphins have got it. tables have turned. They had a chance inside the red zone, punch that thing in and end it. Now we're going the other way.
And it's real easy to just look at them and say, boy, what an error, what a mistake you made. But how about the defense coming up huge?
There.
Let's give them a little bit of credit, keeping their team in the game, because if they score a touchdown there, it's game over.
And he finds enough of an opening to get this one back up to his 20. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4. This being their second opportunity in overtime, 3rd overall drive, see if they can settle into a rhythm.
And that's what you're looking for. Get a few first downs, move the ball downfield, have some confidence, get yourself in a spot where you can at least kick a field goal to win it. But I tell you this, if I'm the play caller, I'm looking at that part of my sheet that says playmakers. Get the ball in their hands, critical situation, now's their time.
They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. The Dolphins on 3rd down. They're hitting at just 30%, 3 for 10. This is 3rd and 4. They'll drop the throw. And this is going to be incomplete. Jabril Peppers, a former first-round pick, there on the coverage. Charles, any chance they go for it here?
I think that there's a chance. They have to consider it because of the way they played offense in this game. I mean, look at the scoreboard. Look at the points that they put up. They feel confident that they can keep it going. But the risk is, and the downside is, you don't get it here, you've set up your opponent in really good field position.
Play fake. He'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. He's got Lockett. A gigantic call there in overtime, but it pays off with a 1st down. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. They go play action here on 1st down. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 23 yards on the play. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now. 1st and 10 at the 47. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Dancing to his left. Now he's going to throw deep. Back up. And this is caught. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Now, partner, a great game that we got to see and making it extra special. Not only did I get 4 quarters.
Johnny Big Redemption, like, know what I'm talking about? Hold up.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Players have contracts that are about to expire. Re-sign them so you don't lose them to free agency.
Win, 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 win.